I heard you got too late last night. Damn, Mayo. Mixing purple with your purple Sprite. Things you shouldn't know. I heard you got too late last night. Damn, Mayo. Mixing purple with your purple Sprite.
Yeah, all good. All good. Back in the gym, just building and working on the next move. That's it. Yeah, I got a few dates: May, June, July as well. So it's up to me, really, pretty much. But we're ready for it. Whatever. I feel good. You know, I got a lot of good feedback. I feel like I got much more to show. I got much more to show, and I've gained so much more confidence as well from that fight. But trust me, man, when I really get under them lights, and just flow. People are not going to want none of this, believe me. To be honest, I didn't have too many amateur fights. I had like 24.
24, yeah.
But a lot of people think I have had 35, 30 plus, but I just had a few. And I started to study. When I went to college and went to uni, I couldn't compete as much because my time management was really poor, to be honest, and I couldn't balance the both. So I just had to focus more on the studying. I had probably like about two or three fights in 2 years or something. So. And then I just went pro after I graduated. It's never too late. It's all in the mind. It's like, it's how bad you want it. You know, if you really want it that bad, you're gonna do everything you need to do to cover up for lost time. Go abroad, take yourself out of your comfort zones, and that's what I had to do. And it brought my skill levels up, and then started competing and just mix with it. Do what you love to do. But a lot of people wouldn't do that. A lot of people don't like the idea of taking themselves out of the comfort zone, but you know, it just limits how you perform in the ring. Because when you start late, you have a lot of catching up to do. There's a lot of training that you need to implement to get that muscle memory so you can react in time and everything is in sync with your brain and you're sharp. But so you need to get into it realistically as soon as possible. But it's never too late, it's never too late. Repetition, and it's never too late. If you put in the energy, you get what you put in. It's that simple. You know, a lot of people say, listen, that's, you know, it's quite inexperienced. He didn't have that much amateur fights, but it doesn't matter. Because, in fact, it works in my favor because boxing is wear and tear on the body. And I've taken less wear and tear than other fighters that have come into the sport with 100 amateur fights, 200 amateur fights. But I can still perform on their level, my hands are still fresh, and I'm hungry to perform and to prove that I'm the best. Yeah, so I found myself involved in the street culture, so how I like to describe it. I was wasting a lot of time getting up to no good, and I found myself going to parties every single weekend, drinking. I was outside a party at one stage and I ended up getting stabbed. Somebody tried to rob my phone. A few others got stabbed, mine was more severe. I had to do an operation, I had bleeding around my lungs. I had to have the blood drained out of my insides and stuff. So, you know, it was really traumatizing. You know, I'm lucky that I don't suffer from PTSD right now.
Sure, yeah.
And it's like after a while I realized that the lifestyle that I was in and I believed in so much was a lie. It was a complete lie. At the end of the road, I thought there was going to be a ton of gold. Women, materials, everything that I dreamed of growing up. But in reality, the only thing at the end of that line, the end of the road, was death or jail. And that's the truth. Three of my friends died. Three of my friends are doing life in prison right now. So it's like they kind of look up to me and are happy that I'm achieving. And it's like they probably think about themselves and what they could have achieved if they was outside as well. So listen, I'm happy every single day. You know, things could have gone left, really, really left. So that's why when you see me, I'm always smiling, I'm always happy, because I know things could have been worse. Yeah, I prefer raw sport because it's natural, and I like to eat a lot of vegan foods at times. I would like to describe myself as a flexitarian. I don't eat red meat. I don't eat chicken, but I have duck sometimes. I know it's a bit weird, but yeah, real sport, you know, represents what I represent, you know, natural, everything natural. And I think nowadays you have to be really careful. Everything is processed, and you don't know the effect that's having on the body in the long term, because there hasn't been that much studies done on this, and there won't be, because it's going to affect people's cells and people's money. So I just believe in taking more natural remedies, and I tried real sport. It was amazing. It was smooth. The taste, the flavors, like when my first batch came, it was like, listen, I need some more. Like, so where you at? where's the next pack coming? But yeah. But yeah, it's a blessing to be working with you guys. Nutrition is so important nowadays. A lot of people disregard the importance of it. When they fight, after the fight, they go on a binge and start eating a lot of fried foods and processed foods. It fluctuates the weights. And one a coach of mine, old school coach of mine, Gary Hill, he's the coach for the GB assessment and the GB boxing team. And he said to me, listen, whatever you put out in your body is how you're going to perform. So if you're eating nonsense, then you're going to perform like that. And I realized, you know what? I need to separate myself by being a bit more intelligent. Why do I need to eat nonsense if I want to perform really well? I might as well put good food, and that's what I'm going to get out, isn't it? So, and that's what I started doing, and I'm seeing the benefits, and I'm seeing the difference. So I'm definitely going to stick on this path. I cannot use any brands that are not, you know, registered under these organizations, because, you know, we get tested as athletes, and it could be really detrimental. If we don't know what we're taking something that's a type of supplement, and then we get tested and they say, listen, there's something in your system, banned for 2 years. That's, you know, that's a lot of time to be to take out as a boxer. And it could affect your chances of reaching your goals. So I just want to clear up this division in the UK, focus more on that, get some more rounds of experience, and then shoot off to the world level. I believe I've got the power to mix on that level at the moment, but I just don't have the experience. So we're just building on that. But trust me, I believe that within the next 24 months, man, big things are going to happen, you know. And you know, we'll definitely be mixing on the world level sooner or later. So we're just working. We're in here, you know, humble and doing what we need to do so we can perform when we get to the stage. People are talking at the moment of seeing me and Lawrence Okolie. People want to see that fight. There's another guy, I think he's Liverpool. It's Craig Glover. There's a few different guys, you know, they're doing pretty well at the moment. And, you know, the fans want to see that. And that's what it's about, you know. Us coming together, making these fights so the fans are pleased, because that's what I do this for, you know. Pleasing, you know, boxing to entertain the fans. Dylan White has inspired me so much, because he came from the same background as I did, and he achieved so much when people didn't think he would go that far. Barry Hearn was saying it like not too long ago on an interview online, and it just shows me that if he can do it, why can't I? It's that simple. If I apply myself better, I could probably do better, you know. That's what I believe in truly, and he's a great mentor for me, pushes me, and that's what I need. That's what we always needed to produce certain type of results. And I think he's perfect for me, he's perfect for my team, and it's a blessing to be working with him. Yeah, so my favorite protein flavor, I'll definitely have to say toffee fudge and banana, real banana. And you know what, my beloved, is it Machi or Matcha? This is the best. This is banging. This is so nice. This is so nice, man. So yeah, like I take it post training, within 30 minutes, and I like to blend it and mix it with coconut water, or if I don't have any coconut water, maybe some coconut milk or something like plant-based milk, pretty much. Yeah, and just mix it and it tastes banging.
Fuck up, you man.
Yo, don't make me laugh.